Okay, this bike has its own story all on its own. I'll try to make this video short, but apparently I have an Uncle Dan in Georgia who loves me, although we're not related. Ah, B. Hey guys, got another custom e-bike build. This is the Gravity bike from Bikes Direct. Gonna go over what we did to it, what the customer wanted, and what makes this thing sweet. I'm Johnny Nerdout. I professionally convert bikes into e-bikes. If you like e-bike stuff and nerding out on the ins and outs of it, check out my other videos. I got a couple playlists on specific things. Okay, let's get right into it. So this is a guy, I'm in Salt Lake right now. This customer is in Georgia and he bought this bike online, shipped it to me. I converted it and now I'm shipping it back out to him in Georgia. A lot of times when you buy a bike online, they'll ship it to you for free. So he just had it shipped to me for free. And now he's just gonna have to pay one way shipping to him for, you know, about 150 bucks, somewhere around there. This is one of those customers who I've got a chance to kind of talk to quite a bit and get to know their story. They have an illness and it caused them to gain quite a bit of weight. And you know, they saw this e-bike conversions. They've been looking at getting an e-bike for years, but you know, nothing kind of seemed right. And I apologize, Uncle Dan, if I'm butchering your story. They saw the custom bikes and they saw this fits exactly what they need. They could buy a bike to outfit exactly what they want. They don't have to settle for some pre-made something that's kind of shoehorned into that's either low powered or super expensive or short range. Now they've got something super powerful, super long range, and fairly cheap. It literally is the best of all worlds. So this customer has an illness that caused him to get sick, put on quite a bit of weight, and now they're looking to get their health back on track. And I think this is gonna do it for him. They're gonna be able to rehabilitate at their own pace because you could set your pedal assist levels. You know, he's probably gonna start off with a lot of pedal assist, but then as he gets his cardio back and he gains his muscles back and he gains his confidence, that pedal assist is gonna keep going down and down and down until he's just, you know, just using it for hills and getting going. And that's the goal when you're trying to rehabilitate on an e-bike. You just use it for when you absolutely need it, but the rest is all on you and you still get a good workout in. Okay, so let's go over what we did to this. This is a Gravity bike, fat bike from Bikes Direct. It's got 26 by 4-inch tires. Because it's a fat bike, we had to go with the 120 millimeter BBS HD motor. Puts out 1,000 watts nominal. About 1700 peak. Put a gear shift sensor on it. You still see it's all got the stickers on it or the wrapping on it because it's going right back in the box to get shipped out. The chain line on this, I had to bump it out a little bit to get the spacing right so the motor didn't hit the chain stay. So in order to do that, it bumped the chain line out quite a bit. So I put a Leckie 42 tooth on and it brought that chain line back in. So now it doesn't jump off in the lowest gear before it was. But now it stays on the lowest gear just fine. And that Leckie also keeps the chain, it grips it better because it's got that fat, narrow tooth profile, so it grabs chains much better. For the display, we just went with a basic 965 display. It's gonna give you all the information. The only thing it doesn't have is real-time power consumption, essentially. It's got a throttle here, 9 levels of pedal assist, and yeah, these fat tires, this bike is a good candidate for, you know, if somebody is overweight or if you plan on doing off-road, tough terrain, you're going out there, you're exploring. You're getting into stuff you shouldn't be doing. You need a bike like this. This is a hooligan ride. All right, let's go do a Johnny Nerdout performance test. Okay, so you could see this bike, it's got pretty filled up tires. I think they're running about 25 PSI. You can see the top speed on this was probably the fastest fat bike I've ever tested. It is a little windy here, so possibly the gust at my back could have helped a little bit, but it's not like, it just comes in gusts. Hill climbing was right on par. If you need more hill climbing with a fat bike like this, just put a smaller chain ring on it or switch out your cassette for a bigger one in the bigger tooth in the back. I've done one where I had a 50 tooth in the rear and a 28 tooth in the front. And for the first 3 gears, you're literally just wheeling it if you full throttle it. So if you need a mountain goat of a climber, put a small chainring up it. Stop it. On it. Ah, B. So if you guys are looking at a bike like this, hopefully this helped you. All right, later, guys. Ah, B.